name is Sydney, and over the next couple of videos, we're going to be talking about this idea of how we're called by name. And today we're going to talk about a story from Luke chapter 19, and it's the story of Zacchaeus. And what I want you guys to do is just go ahead and pause the video when the screen comes up so that you can go over this scripture together as a group. To know about Zacchaeus is he was not a well-liked man. Zacchaeus was a tax collector, and in those times, the Roman government was actually in charge of taxes. So what they would do is they would hire these tax collectors to come knock on doors and ask the people for taxes. But the thing about this is taxes weren't legalized like they are today. We still have W-2 forms, and everything is very legal and lawful. But in those times, there was nothing to determine that. So what these tax collectors would do is they would actually knock on doors and ask for more money than what the Roman government would tell them to give them. So they were actually stealing from people and lying to people and cheating people out of the system. And all of the neighborhoods would know this. No one actually thought they were actually taking what was right. They knew they were stealing and lying to the people. So these tax collectors would come knock on these doors and take more money than they were asked, so people wouldn't like them at all. They didn't want to have anything to do with the tax collectors. They were just kind of like the people that were outcasted on the side. So knowing that about Zacchaeus, he goes and he climbs this tree because he hears that Jesus is coming. And just like the rest of the community, he wants to see Jesus. It actually said in verse 3 that he wanted to see who Jesus was. But he wanted to see who Jesus was, but he didn't necessarily want to be seen. We know this because he climbs this sycamore tree. And a sycamore tree is actually one of the leafiest trees in all of Israel. So this tree is just covered by leaves. If Zacchaeus went to climb this tree, he knew he was going to be hidden. So he goes and he climbs this tree, first of all because he's short and he knows that he's not going to be able to see Jesus if he just sits in the crowd. But I don't think that he would have just climbed a tree if he just thought the reason why was because he was short. I think he climbed the tree because he didn't want to be seen by other people, and he didn't want to necessarily be seen by Jesus because he felt too shameful. He felt like he had to hide. So Zacchaeus goes and climbs this tree to see Jesus, and Jesus is preaching to all these people. But then he looks through the crowd, and he actually notices Zacchaeus. And it doesn't say if he saw him or if he just knew he was there, and I like to believe that Jesus just knew he was there. But then Jesus says to Zacchaeus in verse 5, when Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." So the thing we need to recognize about this is that Jesus calls Zacchaeus' name. And Zacchaeus actually means pure and clean, which is not how the town would have thought of him at all. But Jesus recognizes not only who he is, but who he can be. And he calls him out and says, "Zacchaeus, I see you as pure and I see you as clean." And I think we need to remember the same things for our life, that Jesus calls us by name, and he knows who we are and he knows who we can be. And then the second thing he says to him is, "Zacchaeus, come down out of your hiding." He calls him out of this tree, out of this place of shame, and says, "Come, be with me." He actually welcomes him to come, or he actually asks Zacchaeus, "Zacchaeus, can I come to your home?" And what this actually means is he wants to have a meal with him. And this is actually the highest honor that you can have in those times, is to eat a meal with a friend. So he's saying to Zacchaeus, "Zacchaeus, I want to be with you. I want to be your friend. I want to know you." And Zacchaeus welcomes him to his home, and the whole crowd is like, why would Jesus want to eat with this man? Like, why would he want to eat with a stranger? But the thing is, Jesus didn't see Zacchaeus as a stranger. He saw him as Zacchaeus, the man who's pure and clean, as who he really is. And in the same way, we need to remember that Jesus doesn't see us as a stranger. Maybe, like Zacchaeus felt like Jesus was a stranger to him, maybe you feel the same way, that Jesus is just a stranger to you and you don't really know who he is yet. But that's okay, because Jesus doesn't see you like that. He knows who you are. He already sees the potential inside of you. He already knows that you belong to him. And I think we need to remember that we are called, and that Jesus knows our names, and that he loves us and adores us just the way that we are.